Hello everybody and welcome to another NASCAR KFC Cup Series race here in Season 2, the second of the season. And we're here at Auto Club, and the straightaway speed here is about 200 miles an hour into turns 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. And there should be a wild one here at Auto Club. And let's get the starting lineup underway here. On the pole is the 83 of Jax Chaos, and the 17 of Vale Musco, also on the front row. In the second row, we have the 96 of North Rails, and the 31 of Kyler Anderson. In the third row, we have the 43 of Matt Penske, and the 18 of Dominic Luba. In the fourth row, you have the 16 of Jordan Kate, and the 48 of Silas Orta. In the fifth row, you have Joe with a T in the 9 and the 12 of Peter Miller. And then row 6, so you have the 8 of Mark 666 and Slinky. And then on the 25 is Thunder and the 21 of Carter Joey. Behind them, you have the 41 of Chris Black and the 99 of Sonic for Life. And then in the 40 of Bradley Ream and the 19 of Samet Oskin. And then you have Trevor Collins in the 6 and the 90 of Matthew Hill. You have the 36 of Griffin Lynn and the 4 of the Gaming Freak. And then you have Belint Borkovitz in the 24 and Legends in the 11, your Daytona winner. You have the 84 of Joshua Harrison and the 15 of Lawson Cook. You have David Dixon in the 42 and Cody Goforth in the 60. You have Benny Lynn in the 38 and the 1 of Johnny Cox. You have the 5 of Nathan Stapleton and the 10 of Will Parrish. You have Groove Dude in the 2 and Angel Avalos in the 3. You have the 34 of Caden Lynn and the 22 of Mitchell Collins. You have the 47 of Kyle Meme and the 49 of Patrick Miller. You have the 77 of Windsor Beck and the 20 of Blake Parker. And the 23 is Ryan Durrani and the 14 of Gavin Beers. Both the 14 and the 23 did not pass post-qualifying inspection. And that'll do it for our lineup here at Auto Club. And let's get these cars rolling for the start of the race.
Drivers, start your engines!
The cars are rolling here at Auto Club for the second race of the season in Season 2 of the NASCAR KFC Cup Series. And Jax Chaos will lead them to the green flag here at California. Very nice day, 90 degrees outside at the track. And it's going to be a very hot one for these drivers. But let's see if they can manage a really good day here. Only 38 laps here today at Auto Club, and these drivers are ready to race once again in about over 2 months or so. Actually, over 6. So they took a big break here, and we're ready to go at it again here at Auto Club for the second race of the season as the pace car dives off into pit lane. And here they come to take the green flag. Jax Chaos will take the green flag with the rest of the field. Looking to the inside is a 96 already for the lead. That's North Rails in the 96. And it looks like the outside is going to prevail here. Because on that outside, you can get a pretty big run as Jax Chaos will lead lap one here at Auto Club with Matt Penske following through on the outside as well. Already fanning out three or four wide going to turn one. They're keeping it straight somehow. Dominic Luba all the way on the outside. Does he get a run on the, all the three wide to the inside though? Very big pack. Ooh, the 8 almost got into the 41 there. Joe the T is picking to the inside for second as Jax will lead another lap. Looking back here in the pack. Four wide right here. Oh, they're getting close right there. Close quarter racing already here at Auto Club. Joshua Harrison's like right in the middle of it. Matthew Hill trying to stay out of the 15. And Jax will lead lap 3. Jax Chaos led them all so far. Joe the T took second. Vale Moscow's in third. Matt Penske's back in fourth. And the 31 trying to take that spot away. That's Kyler Anderson, the 31. He's going to take it. Because the outside just gets such a huge launch down the hill. Looking at the pack, they're starting to spread out a little bit. The front five is single file. Peter Miller takes fifth place. There's a 41 of Chris Black trying to make his way through the pack. We're still going three or four wide in this pack right here. Griffin Lynn in the middle of it as well. We got one blocking, that's Bradley Reed. We're blocking the 24 on the inside. But that might not work because he's going to be passed on the outside by Chris Black. But there's a battle for second. The 17 is trying to make a move. It's not going to work as the 9 is going to get help on the outside from 31. And 31 is going to hop in third as well. So it seems like the outside is working a lot more on the bottom is. On the bottom, you have to check up so you don't slide up into the other car on the outside of you. And Jax is staying in front right now. Very good job by Jax Chaos to lead the field in his 83 as the 9 will peek to the inside. Joe with the T looking for the lead. He's trying to get some help from the 31 again. He does. Can Jax hold him off on the outside? It doesn't look like it. Joe of the T will clear for the lead. Very good move from the 9 right there. All dodges in front three right now. Peter Miller trying to break that up though. Slinky and another dodge trying to make it up here as well. Looks like the Dodgers are having a pretty good day so far. So Joe the T will lead a lap. Jack's trying to look for the lead again. He's not done yet. And I think he's gonna be able to take it. Unless the 9 gets a run on the outside, which he does. It's gonna be side by side on back straightaway. And to the inside, can Jax try and get the lead back right here? He's not checking up at all. He's trying to use the drag move to keep that 9 from getting out in front, but that's going to help third and back get into this battle for the lead as well. Matt Penske trying to look for a way through. He's going to have to help Jax. And it looks like Jax Chaos will go back to the lead here at Auto Club. Very good battles here already on lap 9 out of 38. Jax back out in front. Matt Penske looking for a lead on the inside, but he's not going to be able to do that because the outside will get a huge run because Matt Penske had to check up right there. And Jax will lead lap 9. Joe the T is still trying to look for the lead, though. I don't think he's going to give up just yet. Three wide for third. That'll help the front two pull away. 28 is Slinky in the top five. Another Dodge. Like I mentioned earlier. Take a ride along with him. And as you see, the kind of run the top gets compared to the inside. The 96 and the 43 will clear those two cars on the bottom. Bale Moscow looking for second as well, but let's take a look on back at the 25 in this battle right here. Here's your Daytona winner, Legends the 11. He's trying to stay in the middle of the pack. He thinks that something's going to happen up front, but so far that's not the case. And the middle lane is the lane that he's going to be stuck in for a little while. So he's going to try and hope something happens so he can get back to the front here. Looking back again, Cody Goforth all the way in the back here as well. 14 to Gavin Beers, not having a good day. Failed post-qualifying inspection with the 23, and they're still hanging around in the back there, so not a very good day for those two, but Jack's still leading the way. As more cars are trying to go three or four wide. Jack Scales will lead another lap. The most laps led so far. It's only lap 13. Very strong car for Jax today. I wonder if he has any strategy that he can play that could win in the race. Vale Moscow's right on his bumper though. North Rail is back up here in third. The 17's gonna have to check up, and that'll help the 83 pull away just a bit. So it's going to be single file, about top seven. And the rest back there is side by side. North Rail is looking for second place on the 17. Can he dive down the corner and try and pass? The 8 almost makes contact with the 17. So he's going to try and squeeze his way through, try to get second as well. Bradley Reen catching up as well. Another Dodge. Dodge is having a great day right now on lap 14. And Jax is just pulling away because they're battling so hard for second place. And he will lead lap 14. How long does second battle until Jax finally pulls away from the rest of the field? Because right now it's still dead even side by side. With the 8 and the 17, the 96 trying to go 3 wide. He's going to try and peek it to the inside. The 17 clears for second. He's going to try and chase down Jax Chaos once again. Bradley Reem on the outside will prevail, so he's going to take third. Two Dodgers in the top 5. 31 trying to be one of them. To make it 3. The 12 of Peter Miller on the outside. He's going to get a run. Help from 31. Another block. That's Jordan Cate down there in the 16. Oh, we got contact. Oh, they're going to save it somehow. Wow, and they're pitting. Jax Chaos coming down pit road along with Slinky. Wow, I thought they were going to wreck right there. They saved it somehow. Four wide right here because of the checkup. Great driving by those guys to be able to keep it straight. What strategy are these guys going to pull? Because now, they're 3x3x3. And there's a couple people in front of them who haven't pitted yet. Might need to pick only this one pit stop. Oh, contact! And they saved it again! My goodness. The 24 and the 11 somehow kept it straight. The 60 is going to stay out. Interesting strategy that these guys are pulling. Two also staying out. Jax Chaos just got done on pit road. He will be beat out of pit road by about four cars. So that'll put Jax in a pretty bad position here. if he wanted to win this race. Are these guys trying to do some good strategy? Because Groove Dude is leading right now behind, and behind him is Cody Goforth, and Cody Goforth will stay out. Goforth trying to do the overcut here. More fresher tires. He's going to lead a lap here. The only car on track right now that at least hasn't pitted. So it looks like the leader, if Cody Goforth doesn't have a good stop, the leader might be slinky in the 28. And ultimately could make him win the race because he has a pretty big gap over 21. These guys are in a pack right here, coming out of pit road. Kind of slowing down for whatever reason. The 28 is slinky on the outside of Bradley Rame. These guys are coming out with just fresher tires than these guys. And the 40 will block the 28. Try and keep his lap here. If the 60 pits, that is. The 2 just coming out. And the 60 is still the leader here. Where is he? Where's the 8 of Mark? Seems to be the first car out of pit road. There's the 60 on pit road right now. So who's going to be the leader when the 60 gets out? Benny Lynn, has he pitted? I think he pitted. So he might be the leader, depending on the board. It looks like the 60 is still out there. The Mark is in second place right now. Still trying to look for the 60 here. I think he's out of pit road right now. I'm not sure where he is. There he is. He just came out of pit road, so the thing has to change. Yes, so Mark is now the leader. He's going to try and look for his first career win here. At Auto Club, he's got a pretty big gap, but those guys all have help. Slinky in the 28 and the 21. Pretty much all single file behind them. So they can probably catch this 8 car here pretty fast. The 40's got to check up right there. That won't help at all. Mark with not very good season last season. He only did part-time. And he really wanted good finishes, but he didn't get too many of them. But right now he's leading here at Auto Club in his full-time start. And these guys are catching the A car very fast, even while they're battling, because they're in a draft. And the A car has absolutely no help. He's just out there by himself, a sitting duck, basically. And Slinky is trying to catch up and take a win. He has a win in the Samsung National Series at Pocono. Can he try and get his first KFC Cup Series win here at Auto Club? Take a rear camera look from Mark on the 28. When he gets a better corner to the inside, he's going to catch a little bit, but not enough to get to the A car. He's pretty much right on his bumper, though. Can he look to the inside? Carter Joey looking to the inside. This is going to help the 8 pull away. Because the more these guys battle, the more he's going to pull away. Here comes Brad Vaderin, trying to catch up to 21. The 28 has Slinky to the inside of the 8. He's not checking up on him. Take a look here from the 21's on board. Battle for the lead here at Auto Club, almost 3 wide. Carter Joey's going to think better. And the 8 of Mark is getting passed for the lead by the 28 of Slinky. 42 with David Dixon in this pack as well. Where did he come from? Oh, goodness. He almost slid up into all those traffic. And the 8 is going to get help from the 40. And he's going to stay in front of Slinky for now. Top 26 out of 38. Not too long till we hit 10 laps to go. When we reach lap 29, that is. Bradley Green trying to take second from Slinky. He will do it because outside, very dominant. Slinky in the John Deere car. On the inside is car Joey in the 21 again. He's going to check up. So 31, Kyler Anderson, going to enter the top 3. Dominic Luba up here as well. The top 5 is single file now. Here's the other group right here, the 2. A few more groups that are now separated from the field. Here comes the 40 of Bradley Green to the inside for the lead. Does he get it? Or does he check up? He does check up. The outside's going to prevail right here. And Mark will keep the lead. 10 laps to go next time by. Slinky takes back second as well. He's going to try and chase down the 8 car once again. That 8 car looks pretty fast, just like Jax earlier. Able to hold on to the lead. Trying to go to the inside is a 28. He's not checking up at all. I'm telling you, when they're in second, I don't think they're going to try and check up for the leader. As we are now 10 laps to go at Auto Club. Who is going to win this race? Either on pit strategy or a pass for the win. Because Slinky is right there on the 8 car's bumper. Gotta try and make a move that'll fake the 8. And there it is right there. He's gonna try and dive into turn 3. Does it work? He's moving him up. Oh, contact! Almost turned himself right there off of the 8 car. And the 40 of Bradley Green to the inside for 3 wide for the lead. And Dominic Luba is gonna enter the battle as well. Now that they're battling, looks like Bradley Green's gonna clear. Dominic Luba trying to make a 3 ride for second. He's going to stay to the inside to help the 40, unless he's going to try to make a 3 ride for the lead again. Dominic Luba just sending it here at Auto Club. They're going to have to check up on the inside. So Mark will once again pull away as we're coming to 8 laps to go. Question is, do they have to pit again? Honestly, don't think so. But these cars are so spread out that I'm not sure. The 8 of Mark looking for his first career win here in the NASCAR KFC Cup Series. After a subpar a few starts in Season 1. And there's 7 laps to go in the race. There's a car on pit road. It looks like Lawson Cook, maybe. Is that maybe another pit cycle he's trying to start? Maybe the tires are already starting to die out from battling so much. But it's only been about maybe 10 laps or so. 28, just like you're trying to look to the inside. He just can't get there. It's the 30 gear that's not making it work. 6 laps to go. Another car coming up here, bro. That's Matthew Hill. He's the second car to come down, it looks like. So maybe there might be another pit stop that they have to make. Who's got the best strategy here? Do any of these leaders have something up their sleeve to pull off a good strategy? Dominic Luba to the outside. Slinky going to pit road along with David Dixon and others. So they will have to make a second pit stop. Jax Chaos made a lot of time right there, making it to pit road. Lawson Cook will come down as well. Dominic Luba now enters second. He's got a pretty good run right here on the 8. They're coming to 4 to go this time by. Do any of these guys pit? And here they come. Mark, Dominic Luba, and others are coming down. Bradley Green. As a few will stay out. And let's see who gets out first here. Looks like Slinky will. Maybe it's just Javiel only. As more cars coming down pit roads, as I mentioned earlier, this pack is staying out. Does Slinky beat off the rest of the pack for the lead here? As the Legends and the 20 will come in. The 9 and Joe with a T staying out. They might be coming in this time though. They will. As they're all hitting the brakes to come in. The 2 and the 1. The 60 is staying out. He's got another overcut under his sleeve. Matthew Hill trying to catch to the 60 though. The 60 is on old tires. Once again, the 90's on new. The 3 as well, I think. The 28's right behind. I'm not sure if these guys are a lap down because of the 60. Does the 60 have the correct strategy? He's about to pass Mark. And he does. He's going to pass Mark. Is he coming down pit road, though? And yes, he will come down pit road. Oh, no, he won't. He's going to stay out. Another lap, he's going to stay out. Lap 36 out of 38. I'm surprised because I'm pretty sure the 60's on old tires. But he might have gotten extra fuel from staying out two more laps in the rest of the field on that one pit cycle. As here's the battle for the lead. The 9, can he beat the 60? It doesn't look like it. I don't think he's going to be able to. This might be for the lead. I'm not sure. It's coming to 2 to go right now. Actually, white flag in the air. For the 60 of Cody Goforth. With an interesting strategy here. Matthew's not even in second. He's in 15th, probably a lap down. And if the 60 just holds on for the straightaway in turn 3 and 4 without pitting, he could probably win the race. As, my goodness, look at that gap. Benny Lynn in second, 34 seconds back. And this is for the win right here. Cody Goforth coming off turn 4 for the final time. He's going to win a caution-free race and strategy-filled Auto Club Speedway. What a strategy for Cody Goforth. And the 9 was not a lap down. The only car on a lap besides the 60 of Cody Goforth. My goodness. So Matthew Hill was 3rd. Just was a whole lap down. What a strategy by the 60. I mean, he stayed out like 2 or 3 more laps on that one other pit cycle, and it pretty much gave him a whole advantage, about a whole lap advantage actually, on the rest of the field, and he ended up winning the race on strategy. Let's go see the finishing results here at Auto Club after a strange one. So Cody Goforth scores his first career win at Auto Club under strategic fashion. Joe the T gets second. Matthew Hill, actually 3rd on back, are all a lap down, I should mention. But Matthew Hill gets 3rd. Angel Avalos in 4th. Mitchell Collins in 5th. Mark 666 in 6th. That's a tongue twister. Carter Joey in the 21 finishes 7th. Slinky in the 28 finished 8th. Bradley Ream in 9th. Jax Chaos in the top 10 after leading most of the laps in the race. Kyler Anderson in 11th. Groove Dude 12th. Peter Miller 13th. Trevor Collins in 14th. Will Parrish in 15th. Patrick Miller in 16th. David Dixon in 17th. Joshua Harrison in 18th. And Johnny Cox in 19th. Benny Lynn in 20th. Vale Musco in 21st. Samet Oskin in 22nd. Dominic Luba in 23rd. Caden Lynn in 24th. Lawson Cook in 25th. 26th is North Rails. The 25 of Thunder finishes 27th. And Matt Penske finishes 28th. In 29th is Sonic for Life. Kyle Meme in 30th. Gavin Beers in 31st. Again, not a good day for him. Nathan Stapleton in 32nd. Gaming Freak in 33rd. Windsor Beck in 34th. Ryan Durrani, once again, since the 14 and 23 failed post-qualifying inspection, they ended up having actually bad finishes in the race. So, the 23 will be 35th. Chris Black, 36th. Valent Borkovitz in 37th. Silas Orta in 38th. Griffin Lynn in 39th. Jordan Kate in 40th. Blake Parker in 41st. And Legends in 42nd. The Daytona winner gets last in the second race of the season. And that'll do it here from Auto Club. And we'll see you guys at the Monza Oval for race number 3 of the season. But first, let's go see Cody Goforth do some burnouts for his first career win here at Auto Club.